Hey guys, Marius here with the Resuscitation Coach. In today's video, we'll be reviewing the ACLS Tachycardia Algorithm based on the 2025 American Heart Association guidelines. The tachycardia algorithm simplifies the initial management of tachycardia. I will include a link to the AHA algorithm in the description below. Implementation of this algorithm begins with verifying the presence of a pulse with the tachycardia. If no pulse is present, immediately start with high quality CPR and follow the cardiac arrest algorithm. Tachycardia is generally defined as a heart rate greater than 100 beats per minute. Most symptomatic tachycardias will present with a heart rate greater than 150 beats per minute. If a tachycardia and a pulse are present, ensure that the airway is opened, maintained, and protected. Check the breathing rate and saturation and if hypoxemic, provide oxygen or assist breathing as necessary. Check the heart rate and blood pressure. Get the monitor on, identify the rhythm, and get IV access. And do a 12-lead ECG if available. We must decide if the patient is stable or unstable. The primary decision point in the algorithm is determining whether the tachycardia is causing the patient's signs and symptoms or some other illness is causing the tachycardia. The tachycardia is unstable if rate-related compromise with signs and symptoms such as hypotension, acute altered mental status, signs of shock, ischemic chest discomfort, or acute heart failure. If unstable, immediate cardioversion is indicated. To maximize the success of the first shock, the 2025 guidelines recommend using at least 200 joules for atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter. For monomorphic VT and narrow complex tachycardia, the recommendation is 100 joules. If time permits, establish an IV access before cardioversion and administer sedation if the patient is conscious. If the patient is extremely unstable, do not delay cardioversion. If cardioversion is unsuccessful, consider the following underlying causes: the need to increase energy level for cardioversion, the addition of an antiarrhythmic drug, and expert consultation. On the other hand, if the patient is stable, the treatment path is determined by whether the QRS is narrow or wide and whether the rhythm is regular or irregular. The therapy for narrow complex tachycardia with a regular rhythm is to attempt vagal maneuvers. Some examples of vagal stimulation can be to ask the patient to bear down, like making a bowel movement, blow on a syringe, or give a strong cough. Caution should be used when considering carotid sinus massage, especially in older patients. If vagal stimulation does not resolve the narrow complex tachycardia, administer adenosine. Adenosine slows electrical conduction through the AV node and terminates about 90% of re-entry tachycardias within 2 minutes. Before adenosine administration, please explain the process to the patient. Adenosine needs to be given as a rapid IV push followed by a 20 ml flush of saline, and then the arm needs to be elevated. Remember, Adenosine has a very short half-life. Although it doesn't terminate atrial flutter or atrial fibrillation, it will slow the AV conduction, allowing for the identification of flutter or fibrillation waves, thereby allowing confirmation and the underlying tachycardia. If the rhythm converts with adenosine, it's most likely re-entry narrow complex tachycardia. Monitor for reoccurrence, treat reoccurrence with adenosine or a longer acting beta blocker or calcium channel blocker. Expert consultation is advised. Do not use adenosine for unstable or for irregular polymorphic Y-complex tachycardias because it may cause degeneration into ventricular fibrillation. If a monomorphic Y-complex rhythm is present and the patient is stable, expert consultation is advised as treatment has the potential for harm. For stable, regular monomorphic VT, IV adenosine is relatively safe for both the treatment and diagnosis. The first dose is 6 mg with a second dose of 12 mg if needed. Additional treatments include an antiarrhythmic infusion such as amiodarone, 150 mg over 10 minutes, or procainamide, 20 to 50 mg per minute until the arrhythmia is suppressed, hypertension ensues, QRS duration increases by more than 50% or a maximum of 17 mg per kilogram is reached. Take note that saltolol is not part of the 2025 AHA guidelines. For torsades, magnesium is an option. For more information, please review the 2025 American Heart Association guidelines. The link is in the description below. If you benefited from this video, kindly like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell. We'll see you in the next review. Have a fantastic day.